reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
See.
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
I know what I'm doing.
Don't tell me how to do my job.
Or that.
You are free to act as you see fit, Commander. Our role is to offer guidance and advice.
It's up to you if you're smart enough to listen.
Yeah, let's not make them overly mad. I apologize.
Sorry, Counselor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
We just apologized to him? I take it back. Yes, it was.
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Oh, Codex time. Extinct races. Protheans. Cipher. The Prothean beacon downloaded its knowledge into Lieutenant Commander Shepard on Aiden Prime, causing confusing dreams and visions. While the imagery is becoming clearer with time, the meaning of the beacon communication remains elusive. Why can't I pronounce simple words? It has been suggested that Prothean data recording is highly dependent on a certain point of view, what Carl Jung described as the collective unconscious. The cipher needed to comprehend the images implanted in Shepard's mind is the cultural knowledge of a Prothean, the archetypes, biological instincts, and common experiences universal to the race. Since the Protheans have been dead for millennia, it may be impossible to acquire this cipher. All right. It's time to go around and talk to the crew again. Navigator Presley.
Yes, Commander.
No new options.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to assume he just says the same stuff if there's no new options. Joker time. Anything else to look at here? Random stuff that adds to Codex.
I prefer gold to silver, you know, for my metal.
Oh my god.
I figured you'd recommend me for one since I pulled your boots out of the fire.
You sure you want that?
If we present you with a medal, you'll end up sitting on stage listening to politicians make speeches for a couple of hours.
That's a good point. They'd probably make me shave, too. I spent the last 7 weeks working on this baby. No medal's worth that. So, Commander, why don't you tell me why you're really here?
I'm supposing it's... I just want to talk, I guess? I don't know.
I'd like to know my crew. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
I can see where this is going. You did a background check on me, didn't you?
Yeah.
You want me as your pilot. I'm not good. Top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those commendations in my file, I earned every single one. Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease. You mean... Okay. Even... Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you.
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Yeah, same thing. I thought it would be something else. I don't really have options to talk to him about other than that tiny bit about the rescuing us from the ruin. So Ashley's gonna be really happy now. Got another alien on board. Talk to Kaidan first. Just a weird, awkward walking up and then turning.
Do you have some time to talk now, Commander?
Absolutely.
Of course. Have a seat.
We've played it pretty close to the book so far, but we're a long way from backup.
You're not sitting.
We've got some tough calls to make. I'm just saying, try to leave yourself a way out. I've seen what cutting corners can do, and I'd hate to have that happen to you, Shepard. Commander.
Well, I told him to have a seat. Are you concerned for me?
It's a personal observation, Kaidan.
Maybe that's not my place. I don't want to send any bad signals, Commander. Just, working on what I've picked up. You tell me if I'm going too far.
Need powder for face. What's your logic?
I'm listening. Tell me why you feel the need to speak up.
I'm not questioning any decision you've made, Shepard. Let me be clear about that. It's just my experience that once someone lets something slide, it tends to pick up speed. You get my meaning?
What are we letting slide? Cut to the chase.
Alenko, if you have one failure, it's an inability to speak directly.
Sorry. I'm not looking to dump any baggage, Shepard. You know the records about the biotic training out on Jump Zero? They're all classified. Because the Alliance made mistakes. After first contact, Kinetics was set up to track Element Zero exposures and develop implants for humans. Once we had an embassy on the Citadel, Kinetics could bring in experts instead of taking it slow.
Experts?
The only experts would have to be aliens.
Dead on. Turians, actually. That's why Kinetics kept it a secret. They were afraid of what people back home would think, asking the Turians for help when we just fought a war with them.
Why not the Asari?
The Asari would have been more acceptable than the Turians.
Yes, but the company didn't go through the Citadel. It would have made Earth look weak, so they discreetly hired some Turian mercenaries.
Why couldn't we do it alone?
Is there some reason we couldn't learn it on our own?
They didn't know where to start. Hell, it took a couple of years to even link Biotics and Izo. Forget trying to get the kids to move stuff. They had trouble just helping them not break their own limbs.
Ouch.
And their choice of teachers didn't help much.
Oh, you do what you have to.
I'm sure Kinetics did what they thought was best.
It wasn't best for us. They brought in an ex-military Turian named Commander Vernus. To introduce himself, he liked to say, "I was at the helm of the dreadnought that killed your father."
Oh, that's nice.
Well, I told him my dad wasn't in the war. He'd retired to Vancouver. My family had an inland home that matured to new beachfront.
Huh.
Vernus had it in for me after that. He cut corners, pushed hard. I mean, you either came out a Superman or a wreck. A lot of kids snapped. A few died. The point of all of this, I guess, is that when you cut corners, it's not always obvious who pays for it.
Well, I don't see the connection of what corners I'm cutting.
So why are you telling me this? Are you saying I'm cutting corners somewhere?
I'm saying it's probably inevitable that we'll have to. And when that happens, I want to help you. When someone important to you is up on a ledge, you help them. Keep them from mistakes better made by a kid.
What the hell is he getting at? What kind of corners? And help us how? Important?
Important, huh?
I don't know what he's getting at.
Just say the word.
You're not? I don't know what the hell you're in or out of.
You're not out of line, Kaidan. But there are regs.
I get you, Shepard. I don't make a habit of complicating the chain of command. Just think about what I said.
Okay.
We'll talk later, Kaidan.
I'd like that.
No idea what the guy's talking about. Nothing in my locker. Let's check the codex here. Oh, technology. Life is a biotic. An autobiography. An autobiography. Biotics possess extraordinary abilities, but they must live with minor inconveniences. The most obvious issue is getting adequate nutrition. Creating biotic mass effects takes such a toll on metabolism that active biotics develop ravenous appetites. The standard Alliance combat ration for a soldier is 3,000 calories per day. Biotics are given 4,500 as well as a canteen of potent energy drink for quick refreshment after hard combat. Another issue is electric charge. Electricity accumulated in starship drive cores must be discharged, and so must the electricity in a biotic user. Biotics are prone to small static discharges when they touch metal. Unfortunately, human biotics also face suspicion and persecution, beginning with the popular misconception that they can read and control minds. Biotics symbolize the dehumanization of mankind to people philosophically or religiously opposed to gene modification and cybernetics. Militaries are the only organizations that always welcome biotics, offering them huge recruitment incentives. Okay. Anything here to look at? Stuff? Okay. As you were. Now this go. Yeah, they both go out here, right? Okay. But there's these doors, okay. These are my quarters. Nothing new to see. Cutting through. Oh, hello. Manichel. Dr. Chuck, was Liara here too?
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Guess not.
Goodbye, Commander.
Here's Liara. Oh, she hangs out in here. This is your little room now?
Commander. Are you coming to check up on me?
I was worried.
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
She's the best.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from the Geth, Commander. If you hadn't shown up, I...
Don't mention it.
I'm just glad we got there in time.
So am I.
Of course.
I know you took a chance bringing me aboard this ship. I have seen the way your crew looks at me. They do not trust me. But I am not like Benezia. I will do whatever I can to help you stop Saren. I promise.
I guess she knows what happened with Benezia. I figured that was going to be an issue. I guess not. I know.
Don't worry, Liara. I trust you. I know you won't let me down.
It means a lot to hear you say that, Commander. Thank you.
Aww. I'd like to talk about you.
Tell me about yourself, Liara.
Me? I am afraid I am not very interesting, Commander.
Oh, tisk tisk.
I spend most of my time on remote digs, unearthing mundane items buried in long-forgotten Prothean ruins.
I like where this is going. You must get lonely.
Sounds dangerous. And lonely.
Sometimes I would run afoul of indigenous life forms or stumble across a small band of mercenaries or privateers. But I was always careful. Mm. Until the Geth followed me to Artemis Tau. I never found myself in any situation my biotics could not handle. As for the solitude, well, that is one aspect that most appealed to me. Sometimes I just need to get away from other people.
Why is that?
You don't like other people?
I suppose it comes from being a matriarch's daughter. People expected me to follow in Venezia's footsteps. They wanted me to become a leader of our people. Matriarchs guide their followers into the future. They seek the truth of what is yet to come. Maybe that's why I became so interested in the secrets of the past. It sounds so foolish when I say it out loud. It sounds like I became an archaeologist simply to spite Venezia.
It doesn't sound like that to me, actually. It's not foolish.
All children rebel against their parents. It's a natural part of growing up.
Uh-huh. You share the wisdom of the matriarch, Shepard. That is exactly what Venezia said when I told her of my decision. But there was more to it than that. I felt drawn to the past. The Protheans were these wondrous, mysterious figures. I wanted to know everything about them. That is why I find you so fascinating.
Ooh.
You were marked by the beacon on Eden Prime. You were touched by working Prothean technology.
I'm fascinating?
Sounds like you want to dissect me in a lab somewhere.
What? No! I did not mean to insinuate. I never meant to offend you, Shepard. I only meant that you would be an interesting specimen for an in-depth study. No, that's even worse.
Relax.
Calm down, Liara. I was only joking.
Stammering.
Oh, by the goddess. How could I be so dense? You must think I am a complete and utter fool.
Oh, my.
Now you know why I prefer to spend my time in the field with data disks and computers. I always seem to say something embarrassing around other people. Please, just pretend this conversation never happened.
You're okay. Tell me about Venezia.
Do you know why Venezia joined up with Saren?
She was controlled.
Venezia was swept up in events beyond her control and lost herself. She fell under the spell of indoctrination and became part of the very thing she wanted to stop. But I will remember and honor how she lived. Not how she died. My mother was strong, kind, and beautiful. And now she is gone.
Yeah. About that, I've been wondering... Well, don't tell me, guys, of course, as I keep saying. This is just me wondering. I don't want to know right now. I want to find out how the story progresses. What kind of power or technology he used to control her. Lady Venezia. I'm sorry.
Are you gonna be okay?
You are kind to ask, Shepard. I do miss her, and I grieve for what happened to her. But I will not let my grief interfere with what we are trying to accomplish.
That's good. Tell me about Asari culture.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council. And we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Rumors?
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning for us. We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
My interest is thereby piqued. How is that possible?
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term. Not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be involved, but it is not an essential element of the union.
Essential.
The true connection is mental.
It's essential.
Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species.
Wow.
We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
And what about the other parent?
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different. Some unions are a single encounter with both parents parting ways afterwards. Others can be more long-term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
Hmm. What about the age difference?
You Asari live for 1,000 years.
1,000 years?
What happens when your partner dies? I guess so, yeah.
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
Hmm. Who is your father?
Do you know who Matriarch Benezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her partner. Though I know my father, if you want to use that term, was another Asari.
Well, you can do that. Do what? You can do that. I don't know what she means there. You don't know who?
Benezia never told you her partner's name?
Union with our own kind is no longer common. Not for the purposes of reproduction.
Really?
Most Asari believe it weakens our species. Huh. Asari daughters inherit racial traits from the father species. If both parents are Asari, then nothing has been gained. Or so conventional wisdom would hold. I am what is sometimes called a pureblood. Though no Asari would ever be cruel enough to say the word to my face, it is a great insult among my people. It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
That is terrible. So, this is interesting, because they've set up here, which is the opposite of what a lot of people on Earth believe as far as biracial couples, marriage, and having children, that it weakens their line. You know, that, you know, are there any, how many more completely pure Irish people or African American people are there? And they really are against people just, I mean, it's a political thing, obviously. I think it's bull. But, yeah, they're feeling it's weakening the species, and there'll be no more pure, you know, whatever. Irish, Scottish, Welsh, African American, Indian, Eastern Indian, anyway. That's terrible.
How could anyone abandon their own child?
I cannot answer that. This is all speculation on my part. It is possible she wanted to be part of my life, but something happened to her before she had the chance. Benezia never spoke of her partner. Whatever happened, it caused her too much pain to dwell on it. She raised me by herself, though that is not uncommon. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long before the child reaches maturity.
Why does this show up here? Nothing else, then.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Oh, excuse me. My. Now she'll never go out with me. I had a throat noise. Let's check the codex. Council races. Asari government. The Asari came late to the concept of world government. For centuries, their homeworld of Thessia was dotted with loose confederacies of great republican cities. The closest earthly equivalent would be the ancient Mediterranean city-states. Since the Asari culture values consensus and accommodation, there was little impetus to form larger principalities. Rather than hoard resources, the Asari bartered freely. Rather than attack one another over differing philosophies, they sought to understand one another. Only in the information age did the city-states grow close. Communication over internet evolved into an electronic democracy. Asari have no politicians or elections, but a freewheeling, all-inclusive legislature that citizens can participate in at will. Policy debates take place at all hours of the day in official chat rooms and forums moderated by specially programmed virtual intelligences. All aspects of policy are open to plebiscite at any time. What that is. In any given debate, the Asari tend to lend the most credence to the opinions of any matriarchs present, nearly always deferring to the experience of these millennia-old wise women. Achieving consensus through public debate may take too long in a crisis. In cases where prompt, decisive action is required, the Asari defer to the wisdom of local matriarchs. And extinct races. I guess the beacon. The beacon was a Prothean artifact unearthed on the Alliance colony of Eden Prime. Its resemblance to the Prothean databanks recovered on Mars provoked immediate interest from the Alliance and the Citadel Council. It proved to be a solid-state data storage device, part of a galaxy-spanning comm network similar to the modern extranet. Intact Prothean paleotechnology is rare. The beacon seemed to promise another quantum leap of technology, akin to the discovery of Mass Effect Drive and relays. Unfortunately, the beacon also drew the attention of the rogue Spectre Saren Artarius and his synthetic allies, the Gath. A Dawn raid by his flagship Sovereign resulted in hundreds of civilian casualties. The beacon was badly damaged. The motives behind the attack are still being investigated. During the recovery operation, the beacon fired a pulse of energy at the executive officer of the Alliance frigate Normandy. Lieutenant Commander Shepard suffered and appears... Sorry. Lieutenant Commander Shepard survived and appears to have suffered no ill effects. Afterwards, the beacon fell inert. The mechanism appears to be dead. I'll just continue. The Prothean beacon downloaded its knowledge into Lieutenant Commander Shepard on Eden Prime, causing confusing dreams and visions. While the imagery is becoming clearer with time, the meaning of the beacon communication remains elusive. It has been suggested that Prothean data recording is highly dependent on a certain point of view, what Carl Jung described as collective unconscious. Oh, I just read this. The cipher needed to comprehend the images implanted in Shepard's mind is the cultural knowledge of a Prothean. The archetypes, biological instincts, and common experiences universal to the race. Since the Protheans have been dead for millennia, it may be impossible to acquire this cipher. And I don't know, data disks? Despite all the evidence confirming the existence of the Protheans, little is known about their culture and society. From time to time, dig sites will yield new clues, but after 50,000 years of decay, little of value is unearthed. Recent research has focused on the discovery of Prothean data disks. On their own, they are frail and rarely found in one piece. Occasionally, however, an intact disk will be discovered within a console or reading device. To date, over 36 disks have been recovered, and a few of those have been restored to the point where researchers can begin analyzing them. Though it may be some time before scientists discover a way to transfer the data off the disks, they are currently considered the most tangible leads for learning more about the Prothean culture. Okay, wasn't sure which one was the new one, so I just read them all. Okay, and again. Alright, let's go downstairs then. I got the check-in. With, Tally. And Garrus. And Wrex.
What do you want, Shepard?
Personal inquiry.
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Like?
Such as?
I think we've been through this.
Such as? I needed to get out of our system. I needed to eat. I needed to survive.
Why leave?
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
Really?
What happened?
I was betrayed. I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us. They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
What about you?
What did you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray. But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the genophage made sure we couldn't replenish our numbers fast enough. I told them all to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding, at least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
What about Jared?
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes. A meeting on neutral ground. He wanted to talk. We met at the Hollows, near the graves of our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from, and where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
And you went?
Sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
I did. But when your father invites you to a crush, well, there are some laws that even we hold sacred.
Your father?
Jared was your father?
He was. Until that day. We talked. But we didn't get anywhere. When it was clear that I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest. That is why I left, and that's why I'll never go back.
I believe we've asked him about all this stuff.
So long, Wrex.
Shepard.